pH estimation of a water, pH identification, determination of water. So for that we will be using three methods actually. One, as you know from your smaller class, we are having pH meter, pH paper. Meter is also there, pH paper is there. So just what you have to do is take a small bit, take the water and just dip it. If it is acidic, it will change color. If it is alkaline, it will be another color. If it is, and on that pH paper's outer covering, there will be different colors. And what color you got when you dip your paper small bit in the water, just compare it with that char, okay? And then you can know which category it belongs, whether it is acidic, whether it is alkaline, or whether it is a normal neutral water, okay? So that is the first step. Second one is, take 2 ml of your water sample in the test tube. Now what we are using is, we are going for another method, that is we are using a solution, a universal solution, indicator solution will be used to identify the pH of the water. So that what we are using is 2 ml of water, then 2 drop of the indicator. Shake well, it will be a color. And what is the color? Just compare it with the char given on the outer that label of the water. Just compare it, and what color it comes is your pH of the water. So that is the second method. Third method is the standard scientific method, that is using a pH meter. We are having a pH meter, we'll be doing that also. Simply you can put, and there are different types of pH meter. And for you, for the spotters also, they may keep pH meter and can be asked to write comment on the instrument. Is it clear? So please make sure that you be familiarized with all these three methods. Chala cases le pH meter vechittu parikshathu choikkarilla. Sometimes they will be asking all the three. Normally, most of the pH meters in the colleges are not properly working. Sometimes they may not ask. But then we cannot depend on that. We choicha samayam undu pH meter vechittu pH identify cheyyanam. So please be thorough with the practical. Okay, so that's all. Any doubt? You are dipping. So simply whatever solution is given to you, just dip it. Okay, and you could see that there will be color change. There is a chart given on the outer covering of the pH papers, that slip it is given. So what you have to do is simply take one by one, just compare. Just see, please look on nearby. So we will just see. I just simply dipped, right? The normal color is this one, right? Now what you have to do is just compare. What do you think? Just compare with this one. 3. The second one is this one. Just see. Right? So this I got in the pH 7. Now when? No. Right? Little more bluish. Again, can you see? No. Bluish green. Can you see? Right? Almost 9, right? Almost 9, 8 or 9. The thing is, it is alkaline. Okay, we took from this tab. Just see. Neutral alla. See the difference. Is it neutral? No. Not exactly. Little bit alkaline it may be. Am I clear? Blue it is coming. Slight difference will be there, but then you have to observe. There is a difference. See?
isn't it?
Yes.
Do they look similar?
No.
Now when you see this one, it looks almost nearby, right? That means may not be this much alkaline, but then this is also water. Our water body is also the water what we took from us, alkaline. Hope this is clear.
We are using this universal indicator solution. On the back side also you could see a chart like this. Okay, so what you have to do is whatever, take two drops. I'm just putting we got one color, right? I'm putting the same thing, another one, I got another color. I got another color, right? Just guess which color it will come.
Pink.
It's not coming to the acidic, simply compare. What do you think? Almost four, right? Second one, just see. It's not green.
Seven.
Almost seven it's coming. Third one, just see.
Nine.
Can you see?
Nine.
And this one will be almost here, right? Almost eight, or it comes between seven or eight. In different institutes, you may see from the pH meter of different companies, different types. Okay. Here this is a combined type of pH meter in which both the electrodes will be in the same unit. Can you see? But there are pH meters where the reference electrode and the other shallow electrode will be different. We will be putting two electrodes. But then here you could see that it is within that single one. Right? And this one is having another connection. This one is for the detection of temperature, because with the variation with the temperature there may be variation of pH. So normally we'll be dipping both together, but then the pH indicator, this electrode is single one, it's a combined type of electrode. Is that clear? This pH meter is based on a combined type. The electrode, both the electrodes will be present inside the same unit. This is to detect the temperature. Hope it's clear. So what we normally do is, we have to calibrate it. This pH meter is already calibrated. Otherwise, whenever you do after a long time, you are supposed to go for a calibration. Calibration in the sense, we normally calibrate it with the known solution. Like we normally get the pH buffers. Solution also is there. Otherwise also capsules are available. Capsules means pH capsule of 4, of 9 and 7. Buffers are already available. So what we do is, we'll just open the content of the capsule into the standard tube, standard flask you might have seen, in which we prepare solution. We'll just empty that capsule, we'll put 100 ml and we'll just shake. So that becomes, if we have taken the 4 buffer, it will become the pH 4. So we know that it's a known buffer. It's a buffer, right? It's a known one. The pH is already known. So similarly, we'll be going for 7 or the 9. Okay. So what we normally do is, we'll calibrate it with the known sample. Then only we normally go for, when we do some research and all that, we normally go for the testing of the pH. Isn't it clear? If you use it, we have to wash it. Just keep a, just imagine this beaker is a waste box and you are going to wash it like this, right? You have to wash it like that. And then you should have a filter paper also, because you could see that, see, one drop might have been like, the one will be coming at the tip of this electrode. So to remove that, you may need a filter paper. Simply touch the tip of the this electrode, and that will be soaked on the filter paper. Remove the water, because This instrument is used for pH identification. If single drop of another solution is present, and if we dip the electrode with that single drop into another solution, it may affect the pH. It's highly sensitive. That's why whenever you use a sample, after going for the reading, you have to again wash it with the distilled water and remove the excess distilled water using a filter paper. Simply keep the filter paper down. Simply touch at the tip. Just simply touch the with the filter paper. Just touch the tip. That will soak the excess water. Even extra water comes, that may change the pH. Right? That's why we normally have to remove the excess water also before we move on. Now what we'll do is, we'll just, do you want to see the calibration? Want to see how the calibration works? See, here on this machine, it is written as cal, C-A-L. So just press it. Dip in pH 7, right? So just, this is a pH 7, so I am dipping it into the pH 7. Now what they'll be asking is, keep either 4 or 9, that we can choose. See, now they are just, I have added it into the
pH. Once again.
Okay, now it's working. Maybe some problem with the other solution. Can you see? Kuzhappilla chidmadi. Can you see? Now they are giving it as dip in 4 or 9.2. 7 they have accepted. If there is some variation, they will say improper buffer. Now can you see? Can you see? Just come and see one by one. Wash it again in the distilled water. Both the things have to be washed thoroughly. Okay? The last drop also you have to remove. Then next what you have to do is, just take another pH, that is, now I have chosen pH 4. Just say enter. So they'll show calibrating. If there is any problem with this pH, they will say improper pH buffer, okay? Fine, calibration over. So now what we will do is, one of you just do a favor. We are going to take unknown solution. Okay, imagine this is an unknown solution. So we are going to test its value. Again, what we need to do is, we have to dip the pH meter and the temperature rod, and see here there is a pressing button on the back. You have to simply press like this. Okay, so it will help you to change the height. Like, see, can you see the black thing is going up and down? Just the stand will come down and put the electrode. Can you see the reading is going on? When a stable value comes, the fluctuation will stop, okay, and we have to read that value. Now you can see gradually it's going up. 35. It should actually come as 9, because as I said, this instant one, it may give us 9 itself. Now it is like coming very slowly, 8.4.3. The electrode, the pH electrode and the temperature rod should be thoroughly washed like this. simply put the distilled water on the electrodes, right? And once you finish the reading, another thing about this is, as I told you, please remove the excess water. Okay, after that, this will be there. This help to keep the road undried, like it should be in a kind of moist condition. So you should, and it should be protected also. That's why we are putting this cap. Okay, so simply put it. That's it. Any doubt?